Hi guys, welcome to Mishi Blue Tarot, welcome to my channel. This is Neelam and I'm back for all of you with another reading today, and this is again the weekly energy check-in that I do. This is going to be around your person's current energies, their current thoughts and feelings for you. So I have picked up two oracle cards and I'll be picking up more cards to see deeper, as in whatever comes ahead. All right. Okay, so I'll take you through the piles. Pile number one is this raw citrine rock. Crystals are up for sale, guys, in case if you guys want to, please check out my Instagram page. Pile two is the amethyst. And pile number three is the labradorite flower. Okay? All right. So you can pause the video, think about your situation, think about your person, and go ahead and pick the pile that attracts you the most. Citrine, amethyst, labradorite, whichever one attracts you the most, please proceed and go ahead. I'll pause for 2 seconds. Let's begin with pile number one. Okay, so pile one, whoever chose this citrine rock, let's see what are your person's current energies towards you, their current thoughts and feelings, what is going on in their mind right now about you and about this connection. Okay? Okay, I have the East, which is the beginnings, and Two of Scrolls, which is two worlds. Okay, so right away from these two cards, what I'm picking up is that maybe your person wants to start fresh with you, but they're stuck somewhere. I think they have another world as well. You are one thing and there's something else as well. Now, this other world can be work, this can be probably a relationship, obviously, which where they're not very happy. That's the reason why they're looking at a beginning with you. It's a little far off right now. It's not yet there as if, you know, they would want to start fresh, like as if they have, this is their thoughts, okay? They want to start fresh with you, okay? But right now, they could be in the process of trying to figure out what will be the best for, what will be the best possible way for them. Okay, now having said that, I also see that somewhere this person has somebody in their life who's keeping a very close check on them, like always, like probably a little nosy, okay? And that can be a little annoying. They could be a provider, you know, for a lot of people, like in terms of say family, okay? Like maybe their parents, so everything is on them. They have to think of a lot of things before starting anything with you. But the desire to start something is there. Okay? This person seems to be right now feeling quite alone. And in that alone place, they have you. Okay? They feel nice with you. They feel quite happy with you. And it's like... what I am picking up from here is that they really look up to this time or the space that they have, or probably they feel with you. Okay, now with this, I'm also seeing that they have to supervise a lot of things. Okay, now the supervising is a little bit of a task, and that's what takes up majority of their time. And they're not able to kind of do what they really want to do. So this beginning that they are thinking of is something that's still there in their heart. So if you are misjudging the situation, or if you're misunderstanding the situation because of whatever reason, then you shouldn't. Because this person, if they are telling you that they are busy, or if they are telling you that they have a lot of work, they're not lying. They actually are very occupied. Okay, this I can see. Now let's see what else is going on with them in regards to this connection? What are their thoughts and feelings? Their current thoughts and feelings for you, pile one. The moon. They think a lot about you, okay? Specifically, look at this. Probably during the night or when they're about to hit the bed, you are what they all think about. And it's nothing in a wrong way. You really occupy this person's mind. This person has fears of losing you. Because of whatever is going on in their life. I don't know if you've said something to them or you said that, you know, I'm not going to stick around for so long as you need me and blah, blah, blah. So this person is feeling scared also somewhere. They're scared of losing you. What else are their thoughts and feelings? Ah, the sun. This could be a twin flame connection. Okay. This person knows that you are their happiness, okay? And they have this feeling that even if you guys are not talking or even if they haven't paid too much attention to you, even if you've not been around for too long or you both haven't been talking, this person is very sure about you. This person just knows that you will stand by them or stick around with them no matter what happens. So this person has a lot of faith in you, is what I'm picking up. What else is this person thinking and feeling? Queen of Pentacles. So yes, this person just knows that you are always showering your love and your feelings towards this person. It's like, I'll tell you what, it's a zone of respite. It's something that they feel that, okay, I'm seeing this two scrolls here, two worlds. It's complicated, okay? I'm not saying that your connection is very easy. I can see the complications, but it's like, you know, they feel as if God has sent someone in their life who can just help them move or keep moving, irrespective of whatever happens. You get my point? It's like they want to, or rather I would say you are the reason why they probably smile every day, like that way. It's a very beautiful feeling here is what I'm picking up. This person admires your unconditionality with them. Like maybe you've been around with this person all the time, you haven't said anything. You've probably stuck around with them all the time, even if they haven't been able to reciprocate. This person respects that thing about you. But having said that, they are still stuck. So maybe the kind of expectations you have right now, they will not be able to fulfill it at the moment. All right. Let's see. What else are their current thoughts and feelings for you? Justice, the World. Okay, I have World twice. That's fine. Let's see. Page of Pentacles, Queen of Pentacles twice. See, this person definitely knows and thinks and desires you to be their life partner. Okay, this person doesn't have any doubts about this situation. I am, however, seeing that they have to leave a situation to come towards you. That's why probably the two worlds, and then I have the world. So they know this, and I have a feeling that they are working towards it. But in the interim, okay, they want to give you something. It's not like they don't want to give you anything. In the interim, they are giving you something so that you don't feel that, you know, you've been left out in the cold. Okay? I see that this person might be talking to you frequently, and that is their way of giving you a surety that they are there with you or something. Okay? This person fears losing you, and I did say that before. All right? This person doesn't want to lose you in a lot of ways, and I'm seeing that maybe they're stuck in some sort of a karmic situation with this other person that they are with, or whatever it is, the other situation. It could be family, it could be society, traditions, a lot of things. Okay? They could be stuck over there. I see that this person, irrespective of whatever is happening, they just look at you. They look at you, they pay attention to you. Maybe they keep a check on your social media, if at all you have something, or any other way through which they can look at you. They love looking at you, is what I'm picking up from this particular pile. Now, patience is something that you need to bring in this connection, because this person will not be able to right away start off anything with you. However, they are thinking of it in the near future. All right. But the point is, right now it is this. This is the picture. Okay. Let's see how can it be going forward. I mean, just because I see that presently it's this situation, I see like this person living in two places because of, I mean, circumstances. It's not that they really enjoy doing this. It's circumstances that has, you know, made them be this way. Yes, Wheel of Fortune, definitely. And Wheel of Fortune is a sudden shift. Okay, it will change. This person is also looking forward to that change, I feel. Yes, they have to put an end to something, and it's like subconsciously this person wants you to wait for them. Okay, I don't think this person is telling you what it is. But this person expects and kind of knows it somewhere at the back of their mind that yes, you will wait for them, because you have always been that sort of a person who's giving them. Now, of course, giving has its own repercussions, okay? But yeah, this person hasn't been misusing you or anything. That's not what I'm seeing here. This person wants you. This person wants to, they see a life with you in general ahead, okay? Because they really admire you or respect you. All of these things and feelings are there. But at the moment, this is one thing that they really want you to understand about them, whatever they are going through right now. Okay? That is what I'm picking up for you guys. Pile number one, in terms of their current thoughts and feelings. See, the advice to you here, let me pick a card. But however, I can already see. See, if you want this connection to work out, there is a lot of patience that will be required from your end. So if you're okay with that, then only proceed. Otherwise, you know, you will have to decide, because this will take some time, because this person is really stuck in something. TikTok, yes, you have to decide right away if you want this or you don't. You got to like breathe, take some time off and understand whether you want to give this a shot or not. Because if you wait and you become anxious, then it's not going to really help you in your life. Okay, so that is what I have for you guys. Pile number one, I hope this reading resonated with you. Guys, private readings are open, so you can reach out to me. Also, I have two channels. One is for tarot, the other one is for crystals on Instagram. The links are there in the description, so you can check that out if you like it. Tarot channel has and collective energy check-ins every day. So in case if you're interested, you can have a look at that. Take care and bye. Okay, so let's move to the amethyst pile. Pile 2, whoever chose the amethyst here. Okay, let's see. So we are going to be looking at your person's current energies, their current thoughts and feelings for you. I have picked up 2 oracle cards to see what's going on, and I'll be picking up tarot cards to look deeper into the situation at this point. All right. Outer core, fluidity, birth. Okay. Okay, pile 2, what I feel is that outwardly this person is showing you that they are not interested, or they are showing, they could be acting pricey outwardly. But from inside, there is this new kind of feelings that have come in this person. They're not showing it yet. I don't mean that they will be like, no, I don't have anything. No, they might not show you the intensity of the feelings. Okay, like for example, if they're telling you that, okay, I just want casual. So that's not what they're feeling. They want more. All right. But they're not showing this to you for whatever reasons. Now, I wouldn't know the reasons exactly. But there is a sense of upheaval, turmoil, and that whole feeling of, you know, growth inside, like about someone, like someone has stirred up the feelings in a very happy way. This person suddenly feels like doing certain things which they probably wouldn't have done ever in the past. All right. This person now has a vision of some sort. They're not sharing all this, but I'm seeing that they probably visualize you somewhere with them, you know, seeing a picture, all of those things. This person could be also having some external responsibilities which they have to fulfill. This could be to do around with kids. This is general, guys, so it may or may not. So take what resonates and leave what does not. I'll have to just say whatever I pick up. This person could be having some responsibilities. Either they are a parent or they have parents whom they have to take care of, and financially, emotionally, whatever. So this person has a lot on their plate which they have to look at. Okay, that's something that I'm picking up over here. However, this person has a lot of hopes and expectations from this connection that they have with you. All right. So let's see, what else is this person currently thinking and feeling about you? What is this person currently thinking and feeling about you? It's the Devil. 8 of Swords. They are overthinking. Knight of Pentacles and the Fool. Alright, so what I'm picking up from here is that this person has this feeling of wanting to take that leap of faith or take that risk. But they are stuck. And this stuckness is a Devil energy, which is something that you cannot do anything about. Their mind is stuck. Okay, as I said, what I told you was that inwardly they are feeling a lot of things, but outwardly this is what they are showing. So it's because this person cannot really stop overthinking. Now, this overthinking can be that maybe in the past they have been hurt when they have opened up. Okay? And whenever they think about you, all right, whenever they want to start something fresh or they, whenever they want to, you know, tell you how they are feeling, this whole thinking strikes. All right? They start feeling a certain way and it starts to rule their mind and it becomes very complicated for this person to then take any kind of action. So right now also I am seeing that they will not let you go. That's something that I don't see. This connection will go on. But this person will take their own time to open up. Okay? So it's not like this person doesn't, I mean, I would say they know somewhere what they're feeling, but they're not willing to accept it. Okay, it quite resonates with my reading today on Instagram. You can check it out, guys. It's Mishy Blue Tarot Official. Today's energy was somewhat similar. I'm seeing that this person is not really in the position to be able to tell you everything. Okay, and they themselves are not very sure right now. They might have felt this sort of a feeling in the past, and now it's like they want to be 100% sure before they tell anybody about what they're feeling. Okay, so this person is in that energy where they first would want to understand what they're feeling by themselves and then only do anything. They are right now overthinking and thinking about it so much, okay, that somewhere this person is trapping themselves because of overthinking. However, I told you, they have these moments where they want to come forward and be with you, but they just can't because this whole dilemma from the past or whatever dilemma they have just starts ruling them and then they get confused. Let's see, what else are they thinking and feeling about you? What else are they thinking and feeling for you? Four of Cups. See, I told you, it's the similar energy. The Sun. The Hermit. It's like, should I walk this path or not? Is it what it seems like to be? They're in that energy. They're not being able to believe it right now. That's why I said that this person wants to be very sure before investing at all in this connection. It's like somewhere they know that the universe is offering them something. But yeah, I think they're reminiscent about the past. In fact, they are full of resentment because of the past. Sorry, that's the right word. I can see that they are actually being able to visualize that, okay, this is coming towards me. It looks very nice, but I don't know whether I can believe it or not because in the past I believed it and I had hurt myself. Okay, so that's the energy that this person is in about you. Okay, which means that somewhere this person is giving some really deep thoughts in this connection and they want to see where this goes because they don't want to like let go of it at any cost because it is something that gives them a lot of happiness and a lot of joy. I think this person could be a little on and off with you as well because I do see that maybe there are moments when they want to talk. So they might land up talking and then again the ghost of the past attacks and then they get scared. So they just withdraw. Let's see, will they open up in the future if I pick that up? Will they open up in the future? Or will they be able to understand this in the future? Near future. Yeah. I have the Chariot. And the Eight of Cups. I think once you guys meet, okay, what's happening here is, yeah, I think you guys will once part ways and then come back again, and that time it is going to be more sorted. Okay, there is a parting ways, and then there is again a meeting, and that meeting is going to be then stable. All right, let me just see an advice for you, pile two. New life, truth be told. Okay, I guess you are the one who's going to initiate this now. Okay, hear me out. I have, what you should do is have a chat with this person and say what you want, because you're looking for something in your life. Okay, and you'll have to make it very clear to this person, and then I see your parting ways, like, as in, because this person will not be able to give this to you right away, but then I see a twist. Maybe this person will come back again, is what I'm picking up. All right. So, but then you will have to be courageous and take or make this very bold move here. Otherwise, I don't see anything happening, because I do feel that this connection is somewhere possible. But there are some obstructions, of course, like any other relationship. So you're being asked to do this. Okay. All right, so that's what I have for you, pile number two. Private readings are open, so you can reach out to me. Also, guys, I have two channels on Instagram. One is for tarot, the other one is for crystals, so you can check them out. And on the tarot channel, I do daily energy check-ins, and the crystal channel has all the information about healing crystals, so you can have a look. And take care. I shall see you soon again. Bye. Okay, let's move to pile number three, the labradorite flower, whoever chose this. Let's see what are your person's current energies, their current thoughts and feelings for you. As in, we'll be looking at the energies first with the help of these two oracle cards, and I'm picking up tarot cards to see a little deeper. All right, so let's see. What are their current thoughts and feelings for you? Breath and life. The Queen of Scrolls. Okay, this person loves you in the color white. This person is totally in love with you. In love, like crazy. Okay? It's like they feel alive, fresh when they think about you. All right. This person is very, very emotional with you, as in, like, emotionally attached. Now, I don't know if they're showing this or not. These are their feelings, by the way. Okay. At this point, it's like their heart breathes because of you. Okay. This person would want to talk to you. I'm seeing that, and I'm also seeing that they're very pulled towards your emotional nature. Your emotional nature is something that really makes them feel happy. Okay. You might have also kind of done certain things or said certain things to this person, which has led to them understand themselves a little better. I can see here that this person is quite attached to you. We'll see more whether they are showing this to you or not, but I see a lot of green color. So this person has a green world with you. Now, when I say green color, it basically means a world which has emotions, a world which has feelings, okay? And that world belongs to you, like to them and to you. That's what this person feels. I'm also seeing somewhere that this person might write a message to you, okay? And I think, so deal with it in a very calm way, all right? Don't immediately become all hunky-dory and, you know, jump around with happiness, but just be calm, because this person is feeling very, very nice and happy because of the love that they feel for you. You are like someone who brings about that happiness in this person's life. Okay, let's see. What else is this person currently thinking and feeling for you? The stars. This is so similar. Yeah, this person wants to hold on to you. This person, I'm telling you, this person is in awe of you completely. Like, they feel as if they haven't felt this balanced with anyone ever in their life. Okay? They can't let you go. This person wants you, like, really wants you, and I'm actually seeing that they want to give you something that is very stable and balanced. Okay, they don't want to hurt you or anything. Nothing of that sort is there in their mind. No, I am seeing this moving in a very good direction. Okay, this person wants to take the leap of faith. I'm seeing that this person wants to overcome fears with you. Like, I think this person also needs a lot of healing work, and they understand this. They want to kind of do it for you. Yeah. So the realization could have been like very, very severe, where when they understood what they feel for you. Look at this. Two of Cups and the Knight of Pentacles. So your thoughts keep coming in this person's mind, and it's a very, very, it's a very beautiful feeling. It's a very beautiful feeling. This person seems to be really, really attached to you. I don't think they can do without you. I have the Ace of Swords also over here. So, they're trying to make things happen. It's not like they are giving up or the energy is such. No, they're trying to make things happen, like possible with you. All right. Let's see. What else are their feelings towards you currently? I'm seeing that this person would want to meet you and talk to you. Person thinking and feeling about you. Justice, Knight of Wands, Seven of Cups. So, God, this person is so attracted towards you. They can't stop thinking. Page of Cups. Yes, they want to talk to you and let you know what they want to do. They want to work on this connection. Okay. And look at this. Four of Wands. They want something stable. Okay. They want something stable. They are done with every other situation that could have been stopping them from coming towards you. And it's like they could have showed you a very different side of their personality in the past. Okay, but it's done now. They can't keep going on like this. It's like the universe has stepped in and kind of put things in place. So I'm seeing that this person would want to now reach out to you, talk to you, because I'm seeing that this person wants something stable with you. Maybe they're could have been things that have happened in your connection where they feel scared of losing you and stuff. They don't want to feel that way anymore. Okay? They want to make sure that you are there in their life in a stable manner. This person is done with anything that was stopping them from being with you. Okay, they're done with that phase. So I'll just check an advice for you. This person, I see them reaching out to you, I think in the next month or so. Within a month, I see them talking to you about something important that they want to say. Let's see. Let's see what is the advice for you here, pile three. Just relax. And this is a fated connection, pile three. Okay, you got to relax, let things be. Don't fight the fate, okay, basically. And you cannot do it. It's a sense of knowing that will set in now slowly in you. Understand this thing that there are certain things that you cannot fight. Maybe this person has like irritated you with their behavior at some point of time, but just relax. It happens sometimes. This person has had his or her own transformation. So it's a phase that everybody goes through. Okay, so just relax and let the universe do what it has to do. All right, so that's what I have for you, pile three. I hope this reading resonated with you. Also, guys, I have two channels on Instagram. One is for tarot, the other one is for crystals. You can have a look at that. And both have a lot of information around tarot as well as crystals. Tarot page is more about collective check-ins, so you can have a look at that. And I shall see you soon again with more readings. Let me know in the comments if this resonated with your situation. Take care. Bye.